Hi, my name is Ingmar Bruder. I'm a physicist by training and I'm working in BASF as a research scientist. So BASF is the largest chemical company in the world and our business segments are mainly plastics, performance chemicals as for example coatings, functional polymers, functional solutions as for example catalysts or construction chemicals and certainly agricultural and oil and gas. So near 2050 it's expected that about 9 billion people will live on this planet and most of them want to be mobile, and the question is how to find a way to ensure a certain mobility in a sustainable and a cost-efficient way. And one possibility could be to invent cars which drive by electric engines. So in these labs here, my team and myself, we are developing organic photovoltaic devices. And one example, which you can see here, is an organic solar cell. And basically these type of devices were also used in the rooftop of the Smart Forvision. So the main advantages of organic solar cells compared to inorganic photovoltaics is that you can produce them in a very cheap and easy way. You can produce them basically in any color you want to have and they are transparent. So the fabrication of organic solid-state dye-sensitized solar cell contains several steps. So the most important and certainly the first one is to apply the titanium dioxide layer via screen printing. This is followed then by the dyeing process of this TiO2 layer via a dye bath. And finally, you apply the Hall conductor solution and the back electrode on this device. So if these organic solar cells are exposed to light, then the photons coming from that light are energetically exciting the dye molecules. And basically these molecules can convert then the light energy into electrical energy, which finally drives the motor here in the helicopter. So the issue with electricity is that you have to use it immediately, as we did for example in the Smart Forvision when we used the electricity to power the ventilation system in the car. And the other option is that you can store the electricity in batteries, as used, for example, in mobile phones. You can see here, so basically that's a mobile phone charger powered by organic transparent solar cells. And basically here you see my BlackBerry and I can put it here on the charges. And you can see here the clock appears, which means that my BlackBerry is charged at the moment. So one benefit of organic solar cells is that they're working also very well under diffused light condition, which makes them actually very interesting for especially the European market. So even in summer times, the irradiation power of the sun here in Europe will never exceed much more than 1000 watt per square meter. And that means that even if you have a solar cell with an efficiency of 100%, that this is enough power to drive an electrical car. However, these solar cells can be considered as an additional power source, and like this, using this, you can save energy. So if you want to buy solar cells, for example, for your house, you're paying at the moment something between 1 euros and 2 euros per watt peak. And since we want to enter an existing market, we have to be significantly cheaper. And we are planning for our technology to offer our solar cells for prices around 30 euro cents per watt peak. And this is a unique feature which you cannot achieve with existing PV technologies. So what is really fun and what inspires me is to have the possibility within this lab to work together with people having so many different scientific backgrounds, as for example physicists, chemists, quantum mechanics, and certainly engineers.